Hey, it's Fly Guy back again with another 6-inch Marvel Legends. We're continuing on with their Juggernaut Build-A-Figure wave. We're going to get through all the figures and we're churning through them. So here we're on to Iceman next. If you want to pick this guy up, link in the description below to where I got it from. And that is premiumcollectibles.com.au. They ship to the US, UK and more. So check them out. Don't be confused by the .com.au. You can get, they ship just about pretty much everywhere really. So check them out and great prices and really good service. Got these really quickly and very glad I managed to pre-order and get these because they're still in short demand. By Hasbro, allocated everywhere, left, right, and center. So, really hard to get these. So, all because of Deadpool, unfortunately. We'll get to him and talk about that. This figure, Iceman. Let's look at the packaging first of all. We got a nice piece of art on the side of the pack there, looking very cool. That's not John Tyler Christopher, I think, as far as I can tell. But again, we get the Marvel Legends X up at the top. And the X logo on the back. Now there's a nice cool looking little picture of Bobby. Iceman keeps his cool in battle with his ability to turn water to ice and freeze his own body to temperatures below zero. It'd be nice to get a little bit of accessory with this along the lines of a kind of surfboard or something that we've seen in the movies, a piece of ice or something. Sadly, no, we don't get anything here. What might go well with this is Hasbro's Black Series Ray. With the ice diorama and Kylo Ren, that would be kind of cool actually. But it's a pretty basic figure. Hasbro do love translucent figures because it costs them basically nothing in terms of paint. So you'll always, if they can throw one in there, they'll throw one in. And it cheapens out the wave and keeps the cost for some of the higher and newer figures. It's Cable and a few others that are basically brand new mold, so you can reuse some aspects such as Havoc and others. But there's all the figures in the wave. We're up to number three here. Obviously, I'm sure you know the drill. You collect parts and you build Juggernaut. So stay tuned for him and we'll give him a review later on. There's the UPC for people who keep asking. And that's the rest of the package. Let's get a look at Iceman. Very cool. And again, when I hold up to light, you can see there that the translucent effect really comes to town. As the light just kind of shines through it. So it does look very good. There's a really nice effect going on across it. Very kind of translucent overall, and it gives a nice, cool kind of glow. Let me just turn that extra light off there. It might help. But it looks pretty good. Now let me focus in just a little bit, and we'll get a better look at that facial sculpt, because it really is hard to see with this being a translucent kind of a figure. It's kind of a little hard to see the facial sculpt in the detail. So there we go. There's some detail on him, and it's nicely done. There's a, and I've popped his head off. There's a nice detail on the sculpt overall. Love the hair. Looks very good. Ice baby. And yeah, it comes with a couple of cool little bits and pieces added on to the sculpt. We've got some ice on the fingertips there, the little pieces that have been added on the back of the hand. You can see. And on the other hand there, on the fist too, the same, there's that ice aspect going on there. On his back, he gets, using the peck hole that comes as pretty much standard on all Marvel Legends figures, there's this ice pack, I guess you could call it. God, there's kind of really terrible ice jokes here, people. Across the back, and that allows for that to kind of plug on there and adds more ice effect to it. You can see down on the bottom legs down there, there's that ice aspect too. So while the figure has been cheap to make from a paint perspective, this is a brand new figure overall. I think using some parts such as the waist from Spidey, I can't truly tell, but I think it is some parts of an older Spider-Man. But the rest of it, facial sculpt and some of these forearms and all the little extra pieces of ice are brand new. So it is a brand new figure. And it does look really good. The ice, I mean, he's Iceman. So let's get that out of the way. He has to be looking ice-like. So I just think they've done a really good job of it. I think it's a very cool figure. For all the translucent figures I've seen, this has probably been one of the better ones. Super articulated. Very, very cool indeed. I do like it. But I'd have loved some kind of extra piece of ice for this, and I think it's just lacking a little bit. If it could have had that, it would have really just made this figure, I think, not be the peg warmer, which it will probably end up being, or the least liked of the case, if you're someone like me who buys a case overall. All right, articulation on him. As you see, we popped the head. You can see the joint up at the top of the head, so there's plenty of movement back and forth. You could, if you wanted, take that back piece off there. And if we tilt that back, you get a pretty good movement in terms of the overall articulation. and right down. So there's plenty of movement in the articulation of the head. We've got that chest expanding back piece there, which comes mostly on Spider-Man in the Marvel Legends line. So that allows for plenty of movement back and forth there too. There's also the ball joint socket up there, which allows for completely free movement. There's no restrictions whatsoever. So on that hinge is also sitting a swivel for the bicep. You get a double joint at the elbows. Let me put it around the right way and you'll see it. A little hard to move it, but it's there. And down to the wrist as well, we've got a ball joint on that wrist with that swivel too. So very cool indeed. Upper torso, you get a crunch that goes all the way forward and a crunch that goes pretty much all the way back. You get a swivel torso as well, so plenty of movement on that. Up at the joint, up at the thighs, you can see the little pins in there. We've got a swivel on the thighs. A little harder when it's all this translucent plastic. These are a little hard to move, so again, top tip, get a hairdryer just over the figure with heat a little bit. Don't melt it, but it'll help the joints move a little bit. Down to the knees, double joints at the knees. So again, plenty of movement going on there, and you can see the translucency. The ankles have that pivot too, so there's plenty of movement on that rocking ankle, and of course peg holes. So the things that Hasbro never make. So there we go. That is the Iceman figure. Pretty good. I like him. I'm very impressed with him, actually. He's a lot better than I thought he would be. I thought he would be just another figure that they would take the mold and just repaint it like a Bucky cap or something, and that would be it. But no, they've added some nice little features, so it makes it an extra... it makes it a little bit nicer overall, so nice to get some articulation and detail in there that I didn't expect. So that's it. Let us know what you think in the comments below. If you're brand new to the channel, click subscribe. There will be other Marvel Legends reviews coming up very soon, and so will the Juggernaut figure as well. We'll be reviewing him too, so stay tuned, and that's it. We'll be back with another figure coming up soon.